All right, Bachelor Nation, here we go. Becca, we know and love and revere. Dean, apparently terribly unlucky in life. And so here's the thing. You guys have both done this, but the alleged brass ring of getting the ring or giving the ring, or none of that happened for either of you.
Oh, no.
But this is better. They have podcasts.
Yeah.
There you go.
Who needs the ring when you have a podcast? Yeah.
So Dean's podcast has a very good title. It is called I Suck at Dating.
Help, I Suck at Dating.
Help, I Suck at Dating. Yep. At least you have the person. Handsome guy.
Dean, what's going on?
It's pretty rough, you guys. I don't know if either of you or any of you guys watched Bachelor in Paradise, but I put it on display for everyone to watch, and I want to get better, so I decided to start this podcast. You know, I'm not good at it. Maybe if I can help some listeners improve as well, right. That's kind of where this idea
is. What was the part that you're bad at?
Everything, just from A to Z, from top to bottom. So we're going to get to the bottom of it.
But do you think you'd be a good good with a relationship, not just,
husband.
Improve. The hope is to eventually become good at dating, right?
Uh-huh. Becca, what's wrong with him?
Where do I start? Poor Dean.
I think yours is an easier topic, at least. Podcast is called Scrubbing In. So you've been with Grey's Anatomy from the very beginning.
Die hard loyal fan.
All right, my guess is you started watching when you were like 12 or 13.
I think I was 14 or 15.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah.
And then, but here's the ouch. 13 years now or whatever it's been on. Through thick and thin? Didn't you want to give up when Patrick Dempsey left?
That was a tough one. I actually just spent a lot of money to enter a contest to win lunch with him. And I also got, I get a signed shirt, but the shirt said it was an extra small, so I thought I was being scanned, and they're like, no, that's the shirt he's wearing, and I'm like, he wears an extra small?
That's so weird. You know what's so funny? My daughter mentioned that last night. It's a thing where he will fly you out and you can have lunch.
Would that be your ultimate of any experience?
But I almost feel nervous because if I win, what am I going to? There's so many questions. Like, what happened?
In the car accident? Where do you start?
What's going on? You know, he's just playing in character.
Right.
No, that's him. That's actually him.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. Because there's other people in the Bachelor universe who are doing this as well. Why are podcasts the right way to go? Why is that working?
It's just a unique platform, I guess, to show more about who we are, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So for you, on your podcast, Christina, who you went out with, called up and explained how bad you are at this.
Oh, yeah.
What did she say?
Well, communication obviously is my biggest issue, I think, in her eyes. But it's definitely going to continue to be awkward for me and calling exes and all that kind of stuff like a Christina or anyone else. So I hope you guys subscribe because it's going to be awkward. And I'm sure for the listeners, it's going to be awkward, too.
So wait, but how big is the Rolodex of exes that we could call?
Oh, well, not many in terms of like official like boyfriend, girlfriend.
Right.
But what about not official?
Right. So that's maybe one of the topics of discussion is what is official and what's the label going to be like.
Now, when you come in here and say you're terrible at dating in all aspects,
Yes, all aspects.
Really?
Okay. Someone was going to ask. Right.
You know what?
Dean is very honest.
I don't think a podcast is going to help you with that.
Yeah.
Jeez.
I need a hypnotherapist or something.
But are you helping other people? Like, are other
So we have experts calling in.
Bad daters calling in.
We have listeners calling in and giving advice, asking for advice, that type of stuff.
Wow.
It's fun.
All right, good. No, good for you.
Yeah.
And then I would imagine that there are people who are with you as Grey's obsessed as you are.
I mean, I think that's the thing people relate most since I've been off the show. When I talk about Grey's Anatomy, that's the most reaction I get.
Yeah.
And so it's been funny because that and Dr. Pepper and just any other emotional girly TV shows that people cry over is what people connect with me.
Wow.
So.
Well, there you are.
Yeah.
Let's explain all things. Dean's podcast, Help, I Suck at Dating. Becca's podcast, Scrubbing It. But you guys have nice little billboards.
Yeah.
I don't like that.
I put scrubs on and everything to channel my inner Meredith Grey.
Wow. You're nuts.
In the best way.
Not completely right in the head, but I've just embraced it. Now I'm just talking about
it. That's great.
It's the iHeartRadio app, and you can tune into our friends. Nice to see you both.
You guys are great.